guys, welcome back to another video. Today's video is going to be facts about the awesome Slyvester Stallone. Okay, so I actually saw Slyvester Stallone live. He did a live interview in my home city. I actually skipped a day of school and I stayed over at a hotel to see him, you know. So we travelled there, we stayed at a hotel and came back the next day, but it was an absolutely awesome night, you know. He was interviewed and yeah, it was a good night. I went to McDonald's afterwards, but I did get caught skipping school. Well, they sent a letter out basically asking, you know, we know you skipped school, so not an apology, but we want to know why. Or it was basically threatening a fine, but it was only for the day, guys, and it was a once in a lifetime opportunity, so I couldn't miss it. And I was a huge Sylvester Stallone fan, I still am. So, you know, missing one day of school versus, you know, seeing my hero, I'm obviously going to pick seeing my hero. So yeah, here are some facts about Sylvester Stallone. Obviously, because of the Rocky franchise, most of them are based on the Rocky franchise, but you know, I like Expendables franchise, and but my favourite franchise is Rambo. I still need to see Last Blood, so I'm really, really, really excited to see Rambo Last Blood. If you haven't seen it yet, please don't spoil it for me in the comments or anything. By the time you see this video, I probably will have seen it, but yeah. So here are some facts about my hero, Sylvester Stallone. But my main action hero, my, you know, my all time person I look up to is actually Patrick Swayze. But yeah, Sylvester is an actual legend, you know. So yeah, let's go on with the facts. So, writing for a fight. That first Rocky film, Stallone wrote that in 3 days. He was inspired by the 1975 fight in Cleveland between Muhammad Ali and Chuck Wepner. There's actually a film called The Bleeder, guys, about Chuck Wepner. If you haven't seen it, give it a go. I haven't seen it yet, but I'm one day hoping to. Not many people gave the film brackets, which was shot in 28 days, a chance, but it won Best Picture at the Academy Awards in 1976, earning $225 million at the box office, and even scored some sequels. Rocky 4 is the best. No, Rocky Balboa is the best. I always forget about that one. It's absolutely awesome. Everything happens for a reason. It was a bit of a fluke that Rocky was made. Stallone had gone to an audition and mentioned that he was also a writer. The producers asked him if he had anything in the works, and Stallone said he did. He told them about Rocky and the producers were hooked. I'm pretty sure as well he was offered $100,000, you know, for the script, but he said no, I want to star in the movie. And you know, he took a risk. They could have just said no, we don't want it, you know. But yeah, they gave in to his demands, and the rest was history. So, Man of Bronze. There's a giant 2-ton, 10-foot tall bronze statue of Rocky in Philadelphia. That's a major hit with the tourists, but locals and art enthusiasts weren't a fan with where it originally was put at the top of the Philadelphia Museum of Art steps. It got moved to the local sports arena. But ended up back at the museum, this time at the bottom of the steps. I'm not even sure why they moved it, to be fair, because it's an iconic scene in the film, so why not, you know, why not have it there? First in class. At the 81st Annual Boxing Writers Association of America Awards dinner in Las Vegas, Stallone received their first ever award for lifetime cinematic achievement in boxing. Ring of Honor. Honor spelt with no U. We put a U in it here, I don't know why, but we just do. He was also inducted into the Boxing Hall of Fame in 2011, along with Mike Tyson. Some boxing enthusiasts weren't exactly thrilled about this decision, as Stallone only played a boxer on the big screen and hasn't actually fought in the ring himself. was getting in shape for Raging Bull, he actually did fight a couple of, you know, like amateur fights. So yeah, he actually, you know, he actually was a boxer briefly. So Sylvester Stallone's brother, Frank Stallone, was a boxer though. Going ringside on his 36th birthday in 1982, he had a chance to be a manager for the boxing match between Lee Canalito and Curtis Whitner in New Jersey. His brother Frank was also involved during the match. He got to be a corner man for Canalito. Paint me like one of your French girls. Stallone likes to paint oil paintings in his spare time, and Leonardo da Vinci is a personal hero of his. Two of his paintings have even earned $90,000. Another famous name he's a fan of, Edgar Allan Poe. I suppose after Stallone's passing, his artwork will be worth more in the future. Bye bye Sly. Stallone dabbled in the magazine business for a time, a very short time. Aptly named Sly and geared towards a more middle-aged market, the magazine was released in 2005 and had everything from health tips to celebrity news. Too bad it only lasted 4 issues though. I think Sly would do very well online now. You know, like as an Instagram page. Thanks but no thanks. 3 years before the failed magazine, Stallone had taken a chance producing Father Left It, a TV show he created. Although CBS did air this pilot, the show wasn't picked up for any further episodes. Again, sometimes it doesn't mean it's a bad show. It just might be before its time. We're a lot more accepting as a TV audience now. Bulk up like Stallone. He really wanted to make a name for himself outside the acting world. In 2004, he released his own nutrition line called In Stone. I didn't know that, guys. I knew it. I watched a behind-the-scenes feature thing from Rocky Balboa, and but I didn't know his line. It's, you know, his line of protein goods was still going. He had boosters for energy and testosterone, and also had a food like protein pudding and protein shakes. It seems like it also didn't last. A quick Google search turns up very little chance to buy these products. Again, guys, I think it would do really well on the market nowadays. Arnold's got one. Three Musketeers. Along with fellow actor Bruce Willis and Arnold Schwarzenegger, Stallone was a part of a restaurant chain, Planet Hollywood. Oddly enough, Stallone turned down the lead role in Die Hard, which would go to Willis. I have actually eaten at the Planet Hollywood restaurant. I think there's two or three, but I've definitely eaten at Planet Hollywood when I was I was about 10 or 11. I had a burger, I think. Turned down for what? That wasn't the only big role Stallone has turned down. He said no to Superman, which went to Christopher Reeve, the lead in Beverly Hills Cop, which went to Eddie Murphy, and Richard Gere. Looked out when Stallone turned down Pretty Woman. I haven't seen any of those films. Dorothy is not your son. Stallone tested for Han Solo role in 1997 Star Wars film but didn't make the cut. He explained, when I stood in front of George Lucas, he didn't look at me once. Well, obviously I'm not the right type. It all worked out for the best since I didn't look good in spandex holding a ray gun. Greasy. Is it Oh, it's Gear. Sorry. It just didn't make great sense. One actor who he's not exactly friends with, Richard Gere, there was an incident involving greasy chicken covered with mustard on the set of the movie they were filming, The Lords of Flatbush, after a warning from Stallone. Gere's food dripped on Stallone's leg and Stallone responded with an elbow to Gere's head. The director had to make a choice. One of us has to go. One of us had to stay. Richard was given his walking papers. To this day, seriously dislikes me. I didn't know that, guys. I've never heard that one before. But, that's quite interesting. To be honest, I don't like Richard Gere. I like the film Hatchet, where it's got a dog in it. And, it's a true story. The dog's owners died. The dog's owner died and the dog waited at the train station every day for 9 years for the owner to come back. But it's a good film with Richard Gere. But I like the film First Night as well with Sean Connery. But I'm not a Richard Gere fan at all. Not just a tough guy in an effort to get away from his physical. Sorry guys, it always happens when I'm reading too fast. In an effort to get away from his typical macho characters, he signed on for the 1997 film Cop Land to showcase some of his more serious acting abilities. Incredibly enough, he only earned $60,000 for his role. Politically inclined, Stallone is a big supporter of the Republican Party and even donated $15,000 to Schwarzenegger's re-election campaign for governor of California in 2006. In spite of that, he actually supported Democratic President Bill Clinton during his impeachment trial and even held a fundraiser for the Democrats at his home. "I'm not right wing, I'm not left wing," he said. "I love my country." That's a great way of looking at it. "I'm the same. I don't do politicians. I just love my country." But the politicians aren't the way forward. I don't believe in politics. Can't buy him guns. This is the one that I've always struggled with, because the guy's literally known for, having a firearm in his hand for every movie. And, the guy hates guns. I've actually got his autograph. I'm pretty sure it's a fake autograph though, but yeah. It seems almost contradictory considering there's a lot of gun use in many of his films, but Stallone called for a ban on guns in the US in 1998 after one of his friends, actor Phil Hartman, was shot and killed. Keeping the faith. He's on-again, off-again relationship with the Catholic Church. He was baptized and raised as a strict Catholic, but found himself turning away from the religion once his acting career took off. He rediscovered Catholicism in 1996 when one of his daughters was born. However, he described himself as a spiritual in 2010 interview with GQ magazine, adding that he wasn't part of an organized church institution. Man's best friend. Things were pretty rough before Rocky Stallone had to sell his dog, a bull mastiff, for $50 because he couldn't afford to keep him. But just a week later, he had enough money from selling the Rocky script to buy his beloved pet back. That's where things really get interesting. Stallone had sold his dog to a little person named Little Jimmy. When Stallone went to buy his dog back, Little Jimmy got a little angry and he even wanted to fight Stallone. He wanted to fight me and he was going to kill me. I couldn't fight him, they'd arrest me, so I offered to pay double. Stallone had to offer $3,000 and a small role in the Rocky film, but he got his dog back. Third time's the charm. Some women still think he's handsome. He's been married three times. He married his current wife, Jennifer Flavin, back in 1997, but they had been dating for some years prior. And Stallone even broke up with her in an uncool way in 1984. He sent her a Dear Jane letter by FedEx, but just a year later they got back together. All's well that ends well. The time is right. You've heard of Case of Angels, but what about Case of Time? Stallone has a certain time of day when he thinks he looks his best. I'd say between 3 p.m. and 8 p.m. I look great. After that, it's all downhill. Don't photograph me in the morning or you're going to get Walter Brennan. I'm not sure who that guy is. There's a picture of the movie Cobra. I've only seen Cobra a few times, but I like Cobra. S. Mock's the name. He has five kids with two of his wives, and their names all start with the letter S. There's Sage. Sarah Joe. S-E-A-R-G-E-O-H. Sophia, Sistine, and Scarlett. His sons even had the chance to play his on-screen son in two different Rocky movies. Oh, it's Sergio. All right, now it makes sense. Sergio in Rocky 2 in 1979 and Sage in Rocky 5 in 1990. Sadly, Sage passed away in 2020 2012 in Los Angeles. He hardly ever talks about it. He had a, I think he had a sister as well. I'm not sure. The need for love up until he was about 5, Stallone spent a lot of time in the foster system. His parents fought a lot and ignored Stallone and his brother. He said that his attempts to get his many foster parents to show affection towards him was one reason he got into acting. I'm not sure that's true, guys. Oh, sorry, guys. I've got a plastic bag. I just kicked it by accident. But I'm not sure that that's true about the foster parents because, you know, he's always had a lot of love for his mum who's recently just passed away. If you're watching this in 2012, she passed away in 2012. But, I mean, he speaks about his dad a little bit, but, you know, I've always thought he had an okay, you know, relationship with his parents, but I've never heard that about foster care before. Failure to launch. A young Sly thought himself a superhero, and Clark Kent, he wore a superhero costume under his regular clothes. He tried jumping out a window once to test his flight skills, deciding to use an umbrella to help slow it down his fall. It didn't work and he broke his collarbone as a result. Tough guy, kind of hot. He may not be a superhero in the comic book sense of the world, but he did help raise funds and awareness for the city of Sedra in Israel in 2008, along with Paula Abdul and John Voight. Stallone took part in a concert for the city, which had been hit with the ongoing Kazan rockets, which over 7,000... So he got hit by 7,000 rockets in a 7-year period. 7,000, I mean, guys. If I said 700, I can't remember. The old case of use what you've got. He was bullied in school, so he decided he needed to bulk up because the weights were too expensive. He got a little creative with what he used, car parts from the junkyard. He also used cinder blocks attached to a pole to build his muscles. Tearing it up. Nowadays, Stallone's body is built, let's face it. In his prime, he claimed he could bench press upwards of 400 pounds and squat 500 pounds. However, in a bench pressing contest, he tore one of his pectoral muscles and required over 176 stitches to fix it up. That's why you'll see one half of his chest has more veins than the other. If you know, you notice these things, right? I've always known this fat guy, so yeah. It's, especially in Rocky, Rocky 6, you can see it, you know, the veins prominent in his chest. Risky business. I've also heard this story as well. During the filming of Rocky 4, Stallone wanted Dolph Lundgren to punch him as hard as he could, and he did. Stallone ended up in intensive care. As a result, he also wound up with a broken neck during filming of The Expendables after shooting a scene with Steve Austin. That injury was fixed with a metal plate. I abused my body so much throughout my career that I am literally held together by glue, he said. The stuff I took thickens the bones and reinforces the tendons. Can't cut this. How much money would it take for you to cut your hair for a commercial? Apparently there was no amount of money that would make Stallone chop his locks back in 1988. He was offered $4 million to do a beer commercial under the stipulation that he cut his hair, and then was offered another million after he declined, but he wouldn't budge. Owning up. Stallone recently faced charges in Australia over importing human growth hormones that were banned in that country. He hadn't shown valid prescriptions for the 48 bottles of HGH drug, gintropin. He pled guilty to the charges and ended up paying $11,000 in fines and court costs. I've never heard of that one before, guys. Packing on the pancakes. He clearly doesn't hold anything back when he's cast for a role. For his part in Copland, he had to put on a good 40 pounds of weight on him, which he accomplished through pancakes. These pancakes were so big, he said, one of the local restaurants. He said of the local restaurant, you could put an axle in them and drive home. as she rose and he suffered from back issues. Lion P and scalping. Stallone did some odd jobs over the years just to get by. He worked at the Central Park Zoo, where he cleaned out the lion's cages, with one lion even peeing on him. He was also an usher at Walter Reed Cinemas, where he was able to snag some tickets and sell them on the side. He even tried scalping tickets to the actual Walter Reed ones. Who dare we say was less than impressed? I didn't know a few of these facts, guys. You know, a few of his more bad boy moments I generally didn't know. Even though I've seen him in an interview live, he only really talked about his film career as opposed to his personal life. Just a quick hello. Not exactly an odd job, but Stallone guest appeared on the Mexican Big Brother VIP 2 in 2003. He was in the country promoting his movie Spy Kids 3, Game Over, and got the invite to appear just for a few minutes. He was terrible in the Spy Kids. I haven't seen the movie, but I saw parts of, like, his acting in it. He's not a child actor by any means. You know, he's not a good actor to be placing in child-friendly films. He's more of a tough guy action hero. They probably should have talked about that first. Tyrone Stallone kind of just rolls off the tongue. Stallone's mother, Jackie, was a big fan of film actor Tyrone Power and intended to name her son after him. After his birth, she discovered on the birth certificate that her husband had changed the name to Slyvester. Safe to say, he showed them. School wasn't exactly his thing. By the time he turned 13, he had already been kicked out of 14 schools for being antisocial and because of his violent behaviour. He was voted most likely to end up in an electric chair at one point. His mum ended up shipping him off to school in Switzerland so that he could continue his education. Again, guys, I didn't know this. School of Life. In 1999, he reasoned that all of his life experiences and acting credits to be put towards the credits he still needed to graduate college. The request was granted, and the president of the University of Miami gave Stallone his degree for Bachelor of Fine Arts. Fear fetching. Even Stallone has his fears, and he's got to live with them out. He's got to live them out on screen. His fear of heights caught up to him while filming Cliffhanger, where part of the shoot took place in the Dolomite Mountains. He also had to address his claustrophobia for daylight, where he did a lot of filming in a small and enclosed tunnel. I'll do four more, guys. Well, I'll do four more, but I'll do this one, so that's five. Stop, Don't Watch That. The movie Stop or My Mum Will Shoot, I actually liked, but yeah, if you asked him, the actor would say his worst movie was Stop or My Mum Will Shoot. Of it, he said it's one of the worst films in the entire solar system, including alien productions we'd never see. A flatworm could write a better script. Kind of makes me want to watch it now. I actually liked it, guys. It's really cheesy, but that's exactly what it's supposed to be. Kind of like Arnold Schwarzenegger in Kindergarten Cop. So four more, guys. King of the Razzies. As of 2004, Stallone held quite the dubious honour, most nominations for Razzie Awards. He's even won 10 times, including the Worst Actor, Worst Actor of the Decade, and Worst Actor of the Century. Harsh. He also has the longest unbroken streak of nominations from 1985 to 1997. Catching him in his birthday suit in 1970, 6 years before starring in Rocky, Stallone starred in a softcore porn called The Party at Kitty and Studs. He was 23 at the time and was paid $200 to bear it all. The Italian Stallion. After the release of Rocky, the adult film was renamed The Italian Stallion. Never seen it, guys. Never looked for it, but I think I've heard this story. I vaguely heard this story, but, you know. We'll do three more. Between a Rock and a Hard Place, Stallone has said he really didn't have a choice when it came to doing the erotic film. He was homeless at the time, sleeping at the New York City Port Authority bus terminal for 3 weeks. He saw the casting notice and went for it. It was either do that movie or rob someone, because I was at the end. It was at the very end of my rope. Born This Way. The the actor's deep, slurring voice is highly recognisable, and there's actually a medical reason behind it. The lower left side of his face was permanently paralysed because of complications when he was born, which is also why he has an almost crooked smile. The doctor accidentally severed one of the nerves in his cheek with his forceps. I'm not handsome in the classical sense, he said. The eyes droop, the mouth is crooked, the teeth aren't straight, the voice sounds like a mafioso pallbearer, but somehow it all works. Oh, that's the end of the facts, guys. So, I hope you found this video nice and relaxing. Please get in touch with the videos that you want me to do, guys. I'm really looking forward to the video requests. It's very important you like the videos too, guys, so I know that my videos are being, you know, greatly received. So, I hope to see you all in another video. Take care, and please smash the subscribe button.